Happy New Year's, everyone. What's going on? My name's Ryan Kelly, and today is the day that I'm going to be doing my first review of an episode of a cartoon show. I'll pretty much be talking about what happens in the episode and talk about the parts I like and the parts that I don't like about the episode. And in the end, I'll be giving it a rating on if you should watch it or not. So the episode I'll be reviewing today is Courage, a Cowardly Dog, the Windmill Vandals.
The episode starts out with the family doing their own things in the house, when the power starts to go off and on. Of course, this gets everyone's attention, and they soon find out the reason why the power went out. The power went out because the windmill stopped moving. Eustace goes up to the top of the windmill to try to fix it, but he hits the windmill, and a piece of it falls off and hits Courage. My question is, why does Eustace mess up the windmill? I don't think the windmill shook or the wind got him or anything like that. I guess it was a mess with Courage, but if you wanted to do that, then why not drop the wrench on him? This makes the windmill stop running completely. Eustace makes Courage come up to the top of the windmill with him to help him fix it. As Eustace is working, Courage notices a black fog form and move towards them. He starts to get scared, but then it fades away. Eustace tells him he'll be right back and leaves him to make sure that the windmill is still working. Courage's arm slips and the windmill stops again. The same fog as from before comes back, but this time he can see the vandals riding to the windmill. Courage tries to make the windmill move again, and when he does, the fog and the vandals vanish. Courage realizes that the vandals only come when the windmill stops moving. The way that Courage figures out why the vandals keep coming and going was greatly displayed in my personal opinion. He falls to the bottom of the windmill with the wrench while trying to hold the wrench in place. The vandals have surrounded him, but he runs right through them. Courage goes back onto the windmill, and as he's doing so, his backpack gets caught on one of the blades, which causes some of the signs to be revealed. Courage takes a picture of all the signs and goes to scan them on the computer. What happened next is better to watch rather than me explaining it to you.
The windmill was built 250 years ago by the first owner of this farmhouse, Farmer Giles Gallet. He built the windmill for his farm at a time when everyone else was dependent on water wheels built by a horde of vandals. When the water dried up, Farmer Gallet was the only man with a working mill. The vandals hated him for that. But Gallet kept the vandals at bay by carving magical symbols into the blades of his windmill wheel. Legend has it, if the windmill ever stops turning, the vandals will rise from the dead and seek vengeance on all who possess it. Lucky for us, it's just a story.
I really do love the way they told that story. I love the origin of the vandals. And I really do love how the computer cuts out Ryan saying, "Don't worry, it's just a legend." I love that. I think that's great. After that, the windmill stops again, and this time the vandals attack. The vandals do the unthinkable. They actually behead Eustace. That is very messed up for a kid show, but at least it was not shown in the episode. They did handle it very well, however. They make the head look very cartoon-like and the body didn't go limp, so I guess it's not that bad. Courage freaks out and runs back to the top of the windmill and runs on it to keep the vandals away. He stops running and then starts running again to show Muriel that the windmill was the reason why the vandals kept appearing and then disappearing. Why didn't Courage do this sooner? After Eustace's headless body hits the windmill, it completely collapses and then the vandals return again. The vandals behead Courage and Muriel. This leads to a really messed up game of trying to figure out whose head belongs to who. After everyone is okay, they see that the vandals have fallen and they need to rebuild the windmill as fast as possible. They do so and Eustace gets it to work again. The vandals disappear and all is good, except for when they all fall off the windmill and lose their heads. So what do I have to say about this episode? I like the way it was made, I like the dark atmosphere that this episode has, as well as the great storytelling it does. The vandals look great and the explanation for their origin was perfect. Now I don't like how the story was rushed into the ending because they knew they only had a 10 minute time limit for the episode. The ending seemed very rushed, and the windmill was rebuilt a little too quick in my opinion. I understand they don't have time to slowly rebuild it, but it just seemed to be like sloppy and I didn't really like the way they finished the episode. I know it's a small nitpick, but it still bothers me nonetheless. I for sure recommend that you watch the episode to get the full experience from it. That is all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this review style video. If you do, then make sure to get the video a thumbs up and make sure to let me know if you guys have any ideas for any top 10s, reviews, or something like that you would like to see. Thank you guys for watching the video. My name's Ryan Kelly. Peace out.